Right, this is a company called Cad and Dandy. They're a tailor company in Savile Row, and I found their work seems to be very, very good. They've done a special at the present moment on their stand at the game fair. They've done a few ready-to-wear items this year, which they hadn't done before. But we're going to go in and we're going to meet Harry, because I've talked to Harry earlier about making me a suit, and they've invited me to Savile Row, and they've talked me through everything, and I'm going to have my first suit made by Harry and his team at Savile Row.
How are you doing, David?
Hi, right. Yes, as we know, I am going to come to you and have a suit made.
That's right, yeah.
Right, so can you tell me a little bit about the company? How long have you been running?
Sure, of course. We were founded in 2008 by this man here, by James, right. and his business partner, Ian. Yeah. James was a city trader, Ian was an accountant. Both of them had family history within the sort of industry. James's family made cloth. Ian's family were sort of seamstresses, tailors,
so they've been in and around London.
Yeah, so they sort of knew what they were doing before they started. And then moved on to, so that our first shop was in the City of London,
where we
do still have a shop. Yeah. And then we moved on to Savile Row in 2013.
Right, and then you're also... You have bases also around the world.
We do, yes. So we have our own penthouse shop in New York, in Manhattan.
Oh, lovely, yeah.
And we have, well, we own a separate tailor in Sweden called Gutterich, who was founded in the 1760s, is one of the oldest tailors in the world. So they operate under their own name, but they are part of our company.
Yeah, part of the umbrella. Yeah, exactly. And
so
what's going to happen when I come to London then? Because I've aspired to have a handmade suit made for a long time. I've had a few suits made. Yeah. But I really wanted something special this time, so I'm going to come to you in London, you're going to fit me in, and I'm going to have a nice shooting suit made, but I also want a nice wedding suit, actually, for my daughter's wedding.
Oh, congratulations, I didn't know.
It could well be also for my wedding, but, you know,
we've
got to watch the video.
Well, yeah, see how we go.
Which is, yeah. But that's what we're hoping to do, but I'm going to come to you, and I've already tried on one or two bits and pieces for yourself. I like the style you are, I like the cut, obviously, it's just something different, it's really, really nice. I can't turn the camera on, but I happen to be wearing one of your items now, which I do like. I can look in the mirror.
If
I look in the mirror, I'm actually wearing one of their items now, which is rather nice. Linen top, which is really good. I know the model's not that good, but you never know. They're getting old now. So what we're going to do is go through a process. Yeah. So, if I come to you, we start with?
We always start with the cloth. Right. So if you have something in mind, like a shooting suit, obviously that tells us the sort of area that we need to be looking at with cloth. Yeah. I'll grab a bunch just to give you an example. This is the sort of thing that I would probably recommend.
Yeah.
Ettrick is a Lovett mill, who I'm sure many of your followers will have heard of. One of the great Scottish tweed mills. 21 ounces, you know, robust, waterproof, thornproof. Going to be the sort of thing that you're going to be able to, you know, climb over a gate or fall through a hedgerow, but also... Yeah. Keep you warm when you're sitting on your peg. Yeah, exactly.
I've had one or two of their tweeds myself in the past.
And it just comes out. The other big name for sort of heavier tweeds like that would be Harris, but the Lovett tweeds just come out a little bit softer, a little bit more comfortable, particularly in breeks or trousers.
Make sure they're lined anyway.
Well, of course, always. Yeah, exactly. So we would pick the cloth. Let's say, for example, we'd had a look and you told us maybe, you know, about your colours that you like, and we'd gone for something like this, you know, playing with a window pane. Then we would pick our lining. For a country sports suit, we would definitely recommend something on the plainer side. It's just a bit more sort of, just a bit more
sophisticated. Not everybody wants to be as loud as me.
Well, no, exactly. I mean, so we would probably line that, something like that, you know.
Put a burgundy, like, put a cherry
behind it. Particularly if you're having, if we're doing it as a dress suit as well. So what we tend to recommend is we make you a sort of 7 or 8 piece suit. So we would do two pairs of breeks.
Yeah.
It's always a better, it's always a good idea.
Yep.
Waistcoat, suit jacket. Yeah, exactly. Waistcoat, suit jacket, gilet, as you're wearing now, and possibly a Norfolk or a cap to go with it.
I no longer have a big coat to go with it, because these days it's a lot warmer in the winter, so
yes, well, exactly.
I mean, a box jacket.
We can do a field coat as well. We don't do them very often
because
they're not a tailored garment as such, but we can do them.
Yeah.
And then we would get you create a setup with an account on our system. The way we design, I'll try and show, I don't know how well this will come out on the camera, but we would... let me just connect to the internet. Sorry, the signal at the game fair is not that great this year, so we are...
Well, this is the end of the day now. You're actually packing up to go home.
This tent is full of people
earlier, and they're all quite interested. It's quite nice this year. You've done a ready-to-wear, in lockdown, and that you put a ready-to-wear
had a bit of time. During 2020 and 2021, so we sort of experimented, and people like Lovett, whom we use a lot, and they're very generous with their cloth, and we worked very closely with them, and it's been a great success actually. It's allowed us to open a second tailoring shop on Savile Row, so we now have two.
We
also own the coffee shop that's based there as well. So it's all going pretty well. This year's been busy so far, which is good. And this again has been our best game fair ever, so it's all just going in the right direction.
That people are back out. People are
exactly
back out.
Yeah.
They just want to be somewhere and they're there and I think they started to value traditional values. Actually, that's what happens with tailoring, I believe.
Definitely. But also as well, it's sort of part of the current mood, particularly about shopping, is sustainability.
Yeah.
And a bespoke suit is just about one of the most sustainable garments that can be made for you.
Yeah.
There's all natural materials. There's no man-made material that goes into it for a start. Wool is a sustainable material because you can take lots of fleeces off a sheep.
Yeah.
And also, we can adjust it. We can repair it.
Yeah. So when I put on even more weight,
when you lose it, we can take it in.
When I lose it,
you
can take it in.
Exactly.
Yeah. I think there's more chance.
So I don't know how well this is going to come out.
So what we do is we go through the system. Yes, it does.
Yeah. Oh, good. Perfect.
So you've got a system.
So we would go
looking at styles. So we go
country wear. Let's say, well, we have to do each item individually. So we'd picked the, what have we picked for that one? Let's just do it. 817 is that cloth, and our system brings the cloth up.
So we choose our cloth so we know where we are.
Eventually.
We've already picked our style.
Yeah, we picked the style so we know what we're making. Why is it not? The system is temperamental. Okay, let's say we're doing it in that menu. Yeah. Example price. You have to put a lining in it,
So it's a pretty good system, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And when we come to...
And then obviously, from a point of view for myself, you come in and I have a fitting, and then you go for a few fittings.
Completely,
and do it that way.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It's not like just fill a few forms.
And our system works like this, you see. So if we were doing a shooting jacket for you, let's say, we can control all of the options here.
Yeah.
You know, we can do all the different pockets. We can put hand warmer pockets on it for you, like so.
Yeah.
We can do.
But the difference is the personal touch.
Oh, completely.
When I come in, it's the old fashioned, I want that personal touch. So I come in and you say, right, this does fit, try it on.
Exactly.
I've had a few made in the past where you fill in a few bits and pieces, you take your measurements, and it comes with a post, and it fits somebody else. Whereas this time, I really want a situation like the old type tailor.
Exactly.
I come in, as you can see in the model in the corner, it's all tailored correctly, and I fit it, and it suits me. Mm-hmm. And I've it stretched out, so it's that way. That's what I'm looking forward to.
That is exactly it. We try as hard as we can so that you have one, you have your tailor. So we have a team of, I think there's 8 of us now, who are the bespoke consultants who will talk you through this.
Yeah.
And we try as much as possible to make sure that you see one person. It might be that you get to know the rest of the team, but it will be that your orders come through one person, they get to know you, your measurements, your taste, and it's all done that way. Your first fitting will always be in a test cloth, garment hanging there.
You see there, what it does, it's like a liner cloth, and what we do is we look at the way that you want any gussets in it or tapers in it, so they fit it to you, and then rather than start from scratch and then go back to the tweed that we're going to use.
Exactly. Yeah.
Well, that's really good.
And then we keep your pattern. You're a customer for life. You know, the old ledger book with the quill and ink doesn't really exist anymore, but we keep the records. We update your pattern. The more we make for you, the better things are going to fit. And we can make anything from a tweed shooting suit to full white tie and tails and everything in between.
Nice, that would be nice. Well, I'm looking forward to that, actually.
Excellent, yeah.
Which is, you know, it's been a thing I wanted to do for a long time. Treat myself to a certain thing. I do like clothes, so it will be nice. Anyway, I'm looking forward to coming and seeing you in London. So next time we meet, next time we video, because I'm going to do a little series on how we put a suit together.
Certainly.
So next time we meet, we'll be in London. So thank you very much for your time today. I'm glad the show's gone really well.
It has. Thank you, David. It was good to see you again.
Thank you.